be going to the book of Hebrews, chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9. I want to read verse number 22. Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 22. Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 22 says this: "And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission." Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. Father, we thank you for blessing us once again to congregate together. Thank you, Father, for the words of truth that are contained in the volume of this book. For the word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. Open up our understanding this day that we might understand the scriptures. Help us, Father, to get the victory this day as we are strengthened with might in our inner man. And these things we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, whom you sent to be the Redeemer, the Savior of the world. Amen. We are coming out of Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 22, where he says, "Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission." The Bible teaches us about the blood. The blood that the Bible is referring to in Hebrews chapter number 9 and verse 22 is referencing the blood of Christ.
Amen.
The Bible teaches us that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. Another word for remission is forgiveness. There is no forgiveness of sin without the shedding of the blood. Now, the reason why Jesus had to shed blood is because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And because we have sinned against God, we have all become guilty. We're all guilty.
Amen.
There's not a man who has ever graced the face of this earth that was not guilty of committing sin. Romans 6:23 tells us that the wages of sin is death.
Amen.
But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So because we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, that makes us all guilty.
Amen.
Amen. Romans chapter 3 states this in verse number 19. It says, "Now we know that what things soever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped, and all the world may become guilty before God." And I want you to know, because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, we all stand guilty and deserve punishment for our transgressions.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Amen. And when we live in sin, We must understand that we come under the law.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the law gets its strength. Amen. The law, the strength of sin is the law. Hallelujah. I'm going to say that again. The strength of sin is the law. It tells you that in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 56. Praise God. So this is where sin gets its strength from. It gets its strength from the law. In other words, when we break the law, we have committed sin. 1 John chapter 3 verse 4 says that sin is the transgression of the law. And the wages of sin is death. So that's where it gets its strength from. Praise God. And because we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, we all stand guilty.
Amen.
Amen. And this is why the law is so important. Because the law shows us that we are sinners. Paul said in Romans chapter 7, he said, I have not known sin unless the law said, thou shalt not covet. Praise God. So this is where sin gets its strength from.
Amen.
It gets its strength from the law. When we transgress it, sin has a voice and says we must be judged.
Amen.
Glory to God. Amen. And because we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, again, we all stand guilty. There's not one person who can exalt themselves and act like they are all that.
Amen.
When we all stood in the same boat.
Amen.
Praise God.
God.
Amen. Let me read something to you in Romans chapter 5. Let's start reading here in verse 12. Romans chapter 5 verse 12 says this. It says, wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin. You see that?
Amen.
And so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. For until the law, sin was in the world, but sin is not imputed where there is no law.
Amen.
Nevertheless, death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over them that had not sinned after the similitude of Adam's transgression, who is the figure of him that was to come. But not as the offense, so also is the free gift. For if through the offense of one many be dead, much more the grace of God and the gift by grace, which is by one man Jesus Christ, has abounded unto many. And not as it was by one that sinned, so is the gift. For the judgment was by one to condemnation, but the free gift is of many offenses unto justification. For if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one, Jesus Christ. Therefore, as by the offense of one judgment came upon all men to condemnation, even so by the righteousness of one, the free gift came upon all men unto justification of life.
Amen.
For as by one man's disobedience many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. Moreover, the law entered that the offense might abound, but where sin abounded, grace did much more abound. Praise God. Did you see that?
Amen.
Amen. Now, we must understand. Sin came into the world and death passed upon all men, beginning with Adam's transgression. So we understand the reason why death has reigned and brought judgment. upon souls that have committed offenses against God is because of sin. You understand?
Yes.
Does that make sense?
Amen.
Now, because man stood in a place of condemnation and there was no way out, God sent forth his son.
Amen.
Now, when Jesus came into the world, he didn't have the same blood as you and me. Amen. Everybody must understand here that even in the natural, when you are born into the world, you don't have the DNA of your mother. You have the DNA of your father. Come on, somebody. Well, when Jesus came into the world, he didn't have a natural daddy. Come on, somebody. Amen. The angel Gabriel came to Mary and said, thou shalt bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. And when she said, be it unto me, Lord, according to thy word. When she made that statement, the Bible says that the Holy Ghost overshadowed her and conceived in her a man child. Oh, yes, sir. That's called an immaculate conception. And when Jesus was conceived by the Holy Spirit, praise God, he didn't, when he was born, he didn't have the DNA, the blood of a man. He had the blood of his father, the Almighty God. See, man's blood is tainted. It's impure. But Jesus' blood was pure. It was holy. And it had power to work a miracle of deliverance and free humanity from a life of sin and death. Praise God. That's why the Bible says that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. You remember the story when the children of Israel were in Egypt, when God raised up Moses to deliver them out of Egypt. Praise God. The Bible said that God spoke to him. Amen. Just right before they left Egypt. Praise God. When Pharaoh had refused to let the children of Israel go, my Bible said that God spoke to Moses and told him to kill a male lamb. Now understand now, when you offer a sacrifice to God, that sacrifice must be pure. It must be holy. It must be without spot or blemish. Come on, somebody. Because your sacrifice is supposed to be a type of Christ. Are y'all getting what I'm telling you? He said, Moses, I want you to get a male lamb, and I want you to kill it. Praise God. And when you kill it, I want you to take the blood from that lamb, and I want you to paint the two side posts and the lintel. He said, because I'm coming down. He said, and wherever I it amazing that when Jesus came on the scene, he was 6 months younger than his cousin John the Baptist. And when John the Baptist was out in the River Jordan baptizing folks unto repentance, he looked up and saw this fella. Who was this fella? Who was this distinguished gentleman? He was the Lamb of God. John the Baptist said, "Behold, the Lamb of God. This is the one that gonna take away the sins of the whole world." My God, when Jesus was taken to the cross, my God, when he died, the Bible says a Roman soldier pierced him in the side, and out came blood and water. The blood was for your redemption. The water was for your baptism. Somebody say, "Praise God." Hallelujah. It was the blood of Jesus that enables you and I to have our sins remitted. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. And I thank God for the blood. Because of the blood, we can enter back into right relationship with God. Jesus said in Matthew 26, he said, "In my blood is the New Testament, which is shed for many." And because Jesus shed his blood, praise God, the covenant that God made with Israel and Judah can now come into force. Come on, somebody. What was the new covenant that he spoke of in Jeremiah chapter 31? He said, "This is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel and Judah." He said, "I will write my law in their hearts and in their minds, and I will be their God, and they will be my people." In other words, now that a new covenant has come into force by the blood of Jesus, now we can have, amen, the opportunity of having the Spirit of God come to live in us, amen, and help us, and strengthen us, and enable us, and empower us to live the life that God wants us to live. Tell your neighbor, you can't live this life by yourself. You got to get under the blood. You got to receive the Holy Ghost. Oh, somebody, this is about relationship. This is about being a son and a daughter of the Most High God. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Sins of the world. And I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for Yeshua. Hallelujah. Because he didn't have to do it. But because he loved us, he did it. Come on, somebody. The Bible says that he suffered for us. He died for us. And he got up from the grave for us. That we might be justified in him. Somebody say, "Praise God." And when God forgives you of sin, you are free. Come on, somebody. You are free. I come to tell y'all, there ain't nothing like being free. There's nothing like being free. One scripture says, "He that is dead is free from sin. And whom the Son has set free, he's free indeed." Praise God. There's nothing like being free. There's nothing like having liberty. Of the blood. It's because of the blood I can be free, and I can live holy and enjoy God as my Father and Jesus as my Lord. Somebody say hallelujah. Oh, thank God. It's because of the blood. All